Tonight we are learning bizarre new details about the man who was rescued from the muddy banks of the Rio Grande after being stuck there for days.
He has a violent past and only murky memories of the last couple of weeks. Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez has the story.
It's still somewhat of a mystery why Clayton Senn was in the Rio Grande in the first place. Sky 7 flew over the scene Saturday afternoon as rescuers carried him to safety. A high school class heard his cries for help. He'd been trapped in the Bosque mud, doctors say, for at least 3 days.
He made a few statements about taking a hike, just going on a walk, and then all of a sudden becoming stuck where he was at and having no way to get back, no phone. No means of communication.
Clayton Senn's criminal history includes violence.
In 2008, there was an incident in which he committed felony criminal damage to property when he shattered a bunch of windows to a business.
And that's not all. Senn stabbed the business owner but never told police why. He pled guilty in 2010 and violated his parole last December. On January 9th, police cited him for shoplifting at a Walmart for stealing eye drops and multivitamins. Police say the last day Senn remembers is January 17th. He was rescued about 10 days later.
It's possible, of course, that he was trying to stay under the radar and stay off the main streets and avoid being arrested by police, but all he would tell officers is that he was trying to get away from the city and take a hike, and he found himself stuck.
In Albuquerque, Ana Velasquez, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Police say Clayton Senn remains in the hospital. His feet are frostbitten, and it's possible doctors will have to amputate.